Shalom, Islam, Shalom Alaikum, Alhamdulillah, God bless y'all. It's Ed rocking in the morning. That's Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes. That's Teddy Pendergrass singing in there. That what they talking about? You know that was in the 70s, right? So this fake word of God, this fake government, all that shit, it's not anything that's new, right? I'm actually researched. And I do all my own research now. And you would be wise to do all your own research. Man, I done found out so many lies, so many things that I just ignored. It's been here the whole time, but it was really, I didn't think I had any reason to know it. But man, like, once I got sick and stopped practicing, the actual word of God, like, and people that know call it Torah, or we keep Old Testament morals and values, which was the only word of God that was given. Once I started practicing that and got away from myself, got away from designating myself either black, white, whatever, and just start looking at it from the point of being human and what I was responsible for, I got an understanding of a lot of shit to where my personal emotions or what I felt like drove my whole life. It didn't matter whether I was right or wrong. Most guys, I understand this, we're dealing with women. They not looking at that's somebody else with feelings, that's somebody else's daughter, sister, or whatever. And there's no reason for you to look at it like that till you have to look at it like that. And for the most part, you don't have that guidance coming up to say, don't look at it this way or that way. And this is another thing that we failed our kids with. And I see it with the people that call themselves black more than any other group of people. From the beginning, we had an order from our creator to raise our kids up this way and not that way. And we can see how serious that they didn't take it, because what's going on outside don't reflect what's going on in the word of God. The biggest thing being thou shalt not murder, right? Murder. And that's what we see all the time outside. So these kids are apparently don't know that. And you can't charge them with knowing it themselves coming up. Once they leave out the house and that's not instilled in them, you're going to get what their environment is. Now, they may not, what you call mom, dad, your kids may be good kids. But that same good kid in a jail environment going to have to adapt to what's going on in that jail, unless it's taught to elevate above that shit. And your environment, I'm saying, is your jail. And you got to send your kid out there strong enough to know that you can't be pulled in. You know, like, this is what's required of us, just keeping Torah. All this other shit going on down here, Christmas, Easter, all these holidays, birthdays, all these things are pagan celebrations. That is what it is. The majority of people celebrate that and try to wire it in however they need to wire it in and try to classify that as God, right? I stick to the strict morals and the codes of this book, so I can see people coming a mile away, no matter how nice they try to smile, no matter what their title is. Could be grandma, mom, dad, pastor, rabbi. Everybody got a story, you know what I'm saying? But the creator's story is the one that stand out the most to me. And it says, don't do this, don't do that, don't do this, don't do that. And if I invest in that, that's the payoff for me. I won't be the victim of any of that stuff. And as a result, the order, I will be prosperous, because that's what was promised in the narrative of the script. It's easy for people to debate it without taking one step in that direction. And that's another thing that I see. People want to debate me on God. I can't debate you on it because I live it. You can debate because you don't have anything you live by, any code that you can keep. You can change it at any time. That's the policies of men. God is concrete. That's why we call God a man, because it's unchanging. Sorry, ladies, you will waver. Your hair can be long one day and short the next. That's not law. If y'all remotely see a man with a bald head one day and hair the next day, you got something to say about them. But y'all can maneuver through that and nobody thinks anything suspect about you because you expect men to be the same thing all the time, right? All right. That's the word of God, not the word of a sister, because you would change it. And you see in society, it's a feminine rule because it's always changing based on emotions. We don't have laws based on emotions. We have laws based on equity and being safe amongst each other. The law against homosexuality is a practical law. It's not an emotional law. It's not to shame anybody. It was for the society that they lived in to be prosperous and grow, because man on man, woman on woman will not allow life, you know, to reproduce. And not only won't it allow life, it bring forth disease that'll take life away. So that's, you know what I'm saying? That's an abomination. However, in this feminine society, you can get enough people together and con you into some spells of thinking that, well, this person has a right to be such and such. Even with that, I don't disagree with people doing what they want to their body. That's not what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is this won't be a homosexual dominated society, because that's not what we was created to be. And there's no way that I'll live in that, my family live in that, and be subject to something that's against the word of God. When you're willing to stand on that word, what I've been finding out is the word will stand for you against disease, against hate, against all of it. But people not experienced in practicing it. They didn't experience it talking about it. But y'all need to lose some things that come through with some traumatic experience or something that just knock you on your ass to where you can't hear anybody else's mouth, anybody else's opinions, any options that they talking. When it's all on you, the chips on the line, that's when you're the closest to your creator, because you can hear. And when I hit that point, I was never coming up out of that. You can't see the truth and then be comfortable with anything else. So that's another reason why all of y'all are in my life now, and the people that was here before, they no longer here. And you can't just not love people that you love. Like, love is okay. There's nothing wrong with love. But I'm not going to be around you. I don't love you that much to compromise anything righteous or what the Creator got going on. And just like I'm close to most of y'all now, we was bosom tight over here. And everything that y'all attracted to this channel for, it was people that I loved that I spoke first about this when I start, I don't want to say walking in the truth, but being what the Creator made me to be. Not what man is judging me off of. Like, you'll never meet the judgment of man, because he's short himself. And he's going to judge you with him being over top you and never letting you get to that level that he at. And this is not the beginning, but this is how unjust game this world is mapped up off of. You know that the foundation of the United States of America started with British money, English money. They were the ones that prevailed when it was all over with France, Spain, all these other places came here, right? But in the end, it was the Brits, the English, that the 13 colonies, that's the original United States of America, right? All that was done with British charters or money from the royals or royal families that sent nobles here. It's a classism until America, until Christianity, the kind of slavery that they had in this landmass was associated with skin tone. And throughout the world, people have been slaves throughout the world. But somehow when it came to over here, they wanted to make like this slavery was more intense, that lasted longer than any other slavery. And that's just not the case. It's not the case. The majority of the people here weren't slaves. And you have to look back at history to understand tribes, to understand nations, to understand all of this stuff. You just think that you all black, like you one people. You won't consider anything else. You can't take Asia for an example. that continent of Asia, how big it is, who's actually on that continent, what do those people call themselves? You know, they got their nation set up based off of their culture. Their cultures could involve deities in most cases, and it does. Most of these pagan cultures, heathenistic cultures, have multiple deities. That's the thing that's supposed to separate us, the people that keep the word of the true and living God. And that's what this nation was founded on, right? Because you had so many different people coming here wanting to practice different shit. And those nations and countries, you could be killed, executed for different religious beliefs. Hitler, for instance, the story behind Hitler is Hitler hated the Jews. And it wasn't so much that Hitler hated the Jews as it was that Hitler hated religion. He thought the Catholic and the Christian, because some kind of way they're separate, Catholicism, Roman Catholic, but it's all based off of God having a son. I think they put the weight on his mom or some other shit, but this is Adolf Hitler's take on Christianity, and all of this is information that you can use to put all this shit together, because they fractured it so bad. It's pieces over here, pieces over there. And by the grace of the Creator, I just got time, you know what I'm saying? And I don't have an agenda. It's not about money. It's not about me. It's actually about you. And maybe it's a piece that you need that you can use to formulate the rest of it yourself. But a lot of lies was told, and from especially that African slave trade and the Holocaust. These are two of the biggest reasons why the world was existing the way it was existing. But that's crumbling now. And you can see with the event, the overkill with this COVID shit. It's this last cry for this evil hand of control. But they got so comfortable with their lies and the overkill of the lies that the pot just ran over. And now you got people that was on the team defecting from the team, right? So it's a point of letting them smoke the whole pack of cigarettes to where now they're developing the cancer within their own self. So listen to this. This is Adolf Hitler, the so-called Jew hater, right? Because that's what the world teach you, that he hated Jews. And what color are Jews? Think about that. Why this play?
To a milder degree, of course. The leader of the Third Reich held a strong disdain for Christianity as well, especially the Catholic Church, viewing both religions as weak, absurd, and unrealistic, even though Germany was a Christian nation, and Christianity was a part of the European culture. A hatred towards the corruption of the Catholic Church existed as Germany moved to expand rapidly.
Adolf Hitler on Christianity. But you never hear that in your school. They wanna talk about the Jews and the Holocaust and how Hitler hated Jews and it was genocide. And it's impossible for that to be, because the only thing that separated them was their religion. And again, I kind of knew that, but me doing some research on Adolf Hitler, it actually showed me that even more. Hitler didn't care much for religion because he thought that it was flimsy. It they didn't stick to it. He actually respected Islam because how far they would go to stand up on their virtue. So this is another clip, right? And this is me just doing my homework. This is for me and my household. But if you could use it for you and yours, why not? And it's not a price behind this. Y'all understand?
When people think of World War II, Islam is not generally on the list of things that come to mind. Nonetheless, Muslims actually played a particularly important role in the war and became a significant focus of Germany. In the words of the German chancellor himself, the people of Islam will always be closer to us than, for example, France. To understand the chancellor's position on Islam requires some backgrounds pertaining to his general religious views and thereby those of Germany as a World War II power.
And France was in line with the United States of America, you know what I'm saying, which is a Christian nation. And it wasn't about Hitler so much hating Jews. It was the religious aspect. Germany, at that time, it was two things going on that was religion. You could either be state-based Christianity or state-based atheism. Say this.
Although the East German church was eventually able to adapt and find a way to safely exist under the communist dictatorship, there were still far too many societal consequences for Christians to convince the masses to fight against the state-sponsored atheism. So, as life continued on the GDR side of the Berlin Wall, more and more East Germans became atheists, and therefore would raise their children as atheists, and so on and so forth. Since for many people of any faith, religion is often a result of circumstances and an inherited affiliation, the more Christians that switch to the state-sponsored faithless belief, the more that would soon follow.
It was all political. Like I said, there's one order to Creator, and that's Torah, to keep that, to eat this way, to behave this way. The rest of this stuff is enchantments, memberships, and it should be really plain right now. And everybody's still deferring to Jesus. And we grown people, y'all. Like, you can't believe that it's got to be somebody that come between you and the Creator. And one of the reasons that I stand against, like, Muslims as a group is because they're religious as well. It's no man over the rest of us. Now, some of us may have more gifts or better understanding of certain things than other people, but that's with all of us. So if I know a man that knows how to fix cars, that's not that he's any higher than me. That's just his gift, and I'm not jealous of his gift. I actually need his gift, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not fighting that brother in that, and especially if I see his work. It's one thing to say, yeah, I'm a mechanic. There's a lot of brothers on YouTube, on these YouTube streets, that's, let's say, they mechanics, right? But you don't see any work, any kind of resume, somebody with their job saying, yo, look, this is what they did, my car is fixed. And I'm just using that in the sense of saying movement, right? So for me, I'm my own mechanic. And you've seen what I repaired for myself by way of the taxes or the driver's license. And I do that in the vein of our Creator, because I haven't done anything to anybody. So nobody should be asking me to compensate them for anything, at least not all of me working, right? Now, the reason that that don't work is because the government is corrupt. They won't side with the word of God, which is the Constitution. That's what it's based on. Any of y'all think that God wants me to pay the government taxes? Well, wants you to pay the government taxes? Or can you show me that where God said that? Because that does count, y'all. You know, you have to be able to show that. And what you get is bullied by the government because they're supposed to work for my benefit and your benefit. It's become a business where they're taking money from us and making us think that they're in charge of us. But if you can't understand who God is, if it's a man before you, you always gonna wait for a man to deliver you. And you supposed to be self-Lord and master, and it's easy to achieve that with Torah. So I can't look at things the same way everybody else look at them, because they look at things emotionally. Law is not emotion. They exhibit law on most people that don't know. They use it against you. Like when you go to court and you get a question asked, it's a yes or no question. Y'all want to give a reason or a rationale, and it seems like that attorney gets roaring like, oh, it's a yes or no question. No further questions, and cut you off. It's a yes or no question. It's not what your emotions involved. It's not what, well, don't you think that? No, like driving and traveling, law versus legality, right? Law trumps legality every day of the week. But if you don't know how to present the law, your government, the people that are supposed to be governing with your best interest, not with them as an organization, because that's serving people. That's a job of servitude, not a job of the people serving you. So all the governors throughout the history was supposed to govern with people in mind. When the Creator gave the law, he gave it to elders and honorable men to pass down for generation and generation. We see in the story of Samuel that his son subverted justice, you know, and everybody didn't follow it. It's not that the workout won't get you buffed. It's everybody don't follow the workout that's saying they following the workout. Then when you see how scrawny they are, you're like, oh, this workout don't work. It's not the workout. It's the representative of the workout. So we got people running off from God because Jesus is a bad representative. Muhammad is a bad representative. Your rabbi, pastor, first lady, all of these are bad representatives. So the word of God never gets access. It's all these policies, legalities. And I've shown people the straight word of God. I can't say that I got it from this person or that person. Those are my videos with me in the sauce, me in the shit, me against the judge, the police, time and time again. So at this point, what I realized about man is he'll always need more proof while not proving anything is fucking so. So that's checkmate for me. I'm in the zone now where I know men just don't want to move. They don't need me to be right because it'll show, and it's not for every male, but it's for you so-called strong men. It'll show the weakness in you if I'm absolutely right about what I'm saying. So it's a lot of men in these YouTube streets that deflect too. You know, they've been around me. I know some of y'all see the videos, but you afraid that I'll get views when I'm not after views. It's the information. And the problem is it takes views to get the information out. They're not even secure enough to steal information for themselves or whatever, show the video, whatever, just get the information out. If I hear somebody doing something like this brother Ali Muhammad, I don't agree with a lot of the shit he says, but when he's on point, he's on point. And I'm not a hater that way. It don't take any of y'all, Jarrell, OGP, Brennan, Sister Jackie, Dr. Chu, Sister Crystal, fuck, DJ Tarzan. Who else am I missing? Miriam Ali. I'm not worried about telling y'all about some other brothers with information that you won't come back here again. You know, it's like they think you got to rock with them and that's it. You need all kinds of things. It's vegetables, it's meat, it's carbs. That's a complete diet. And if they giving you shit that's building you, I'm going to push you in that direction. You know, that suits me as well, because if it rub off on everybody, say righteousness rubbed off like evil did. But we always maneuver from the other way. We think that the darkness is really it. But the light is way more powerful than the darkness. It's just that people scared to turn the light on because it shines it on their own darkness. And don't nobody want to be accountable. But that's the only way to get past, acknowledge where you went wrong at, you know, passionately, and change it passionately. That's the only way, the access to Creator. And it's only through the Creator's word, because you don't know what to change. I mean, I celebrated Christmas, Easter, everybody's birthday. And then this word, that's not kosher, pun intended. An actual whole book is not kosher. That's another lie. People creating identities for themselves. And it's through this word that I understand who Jews are not, who Muslims are not, who Christian are not. They are not mentioned in the book. So I don't give any reverence to any of them. You know what I'm saying? Man and woman, as far as I'll take it with anybody. And when I'm explaining stuff, I may use black and white because that's what people identify with. And it's so hard to just say white people or black people nowadays with behavior, because honestly, being an honest, forthcoming man, I can look back now and see nobody white ever did anything that was a detriment to my growth or me surviving in this world. The letdowns I had came in my house first. My mom not preparing me for this shit. One, not thinking at the age 17, because it's your job. You know, you just having babies at 17 and rolling the dice saying it's going to be all right. You can't charge white people for that in any generation. Nobody sat back, took enough time to think what kind of life that baby might have as a result of you having a baby that early, and then deflected the white people. Let me let y'all hear something else, y'all. Hey, Molly. What's up, girl? I can't find it, y'all. Here we go.
The fact that so many black families today consist of women with fatherless children has been said by many to be a legacy of slavery. Yet most black children grew up in two-parent families, even under slavery itself, and for generations thereafter. As recently as 1960, two-thirds of black children were still living in two-parent families. A century ago, a slightly higher percentage of blacks were married than were whites. In some years, a slightly higher percentage of blacks were in the labor force than were whites. The reasons for changes for the worse in these and other patterns must be sought in our own times. Whatever the reasons for the disintegration of the black family, it escalated to the current disastrous level well over a century after the end of slavery.
After 100 years after slavery, what was going on in all those years? What happened? Your brother Malcolm had a take on that too. Let's listen. I like doing this, y'all, because these are tools that we should be using. You know, these are tools that we should be using, passing it on to the next generation.
Now, let me ask, your mention of white immigrants just coming here proves the inability of Negroes to solve this problem by the present course or the past course that they've been taking. Well, it's true, Italians, French, Spanish, and others came here as immigrants, uneducated, poverty-stricken. And their parents were able to open up stores, little stores. They lived in the back, sent their children to school. Their children studied business and came back and expanded the businesses. And most businesses in the white community today are called so-and-so brothers, so-and-so and son, and so forth. This is how you establish what you call the American economy, somewhat speaking on the run. Negroes have been here free since 1865, so-called, have a purchasing power of $20 billion per year, have more education than any group, any minority group on this earth. You can't go in the Negro community anywhere in the Bay Area and find five businesses owned by Negroes, so-and-so and son, or so-and-so brothers. The mistake that we made differs from the mistake you didn't make. Your parents solved your problems economically, of their own volition, with their own ingenuity. Our leaders have done nothing to teach us how to spurn business. They've done nothing to teach us how to elevate the level of our schools. They've done nothing to teach us how to keep up the standard of our community. It is not the masses of black people who are at fault for this. It's this Negro puppet that the white liberal has set over the Negro community to act as our leader and act as our spokesman, who has failed to show us how to solve our own problems, so we remain crippled.
How about that? How about that, Malcolm? And who's the Negro leaders, y'all? Who did he consider Negro leaders? Let's see. My bad, y'all. Wrong shit.
We just told you a little while ago, these leaders that they called leaders, this included Lena Horne, this included Dick Gregory. I just told you a little while ago, these leaders that they called leaders, this included Lena Horne, this included Dick Gregory, and this included comedians, comics, trumpet players, baseball players. Show me in the white community where a comedian is a white leader. Show me in the white community where a singer is a white leader, or a dancer or a trumpet player is a white leader. These aren't leaders. These are puppets and clowns that have been set up over the white community and or over the black community by the white community, and have been made celebrities and usually say exactly what they know that the white man wants to hear.
Now, me, with the black and white part of it now, I graduated from that, and I understand the difference between liberals and conservatives. And thanks to Malcolm, and it's Malcolm such an enigma, because he understood it But I could still see some of the emotionalism or the attachment to the blackness and what he was saying, but he was brilliant. And where he was in the heat of the moment, dealing with that, I'm not. I can sit back and look at it with a calmer head. And thanks to him, like, it's up to that level. I didn't have to dig all the stuff that he dug out. But as a result of him, I get the benefit from what he did. So that's why I consider Malcolm an ancestor, because what he did, I get the build from that. You know what I'm saying? I get to come up from what Malcolm started, because even though all of it may not have been right, enough of it is right to point me in that direction. And that's what we supposed to do, like fine tune with the generation before us left. And this is Malcolm talking about whites, and then he goes into white liberals. Like, listen to this, y'all.
Negro leaders. These are puppets.
Wait, that's not it. I'm sorry. Hold on. I forgot the names of the stuff.
Religious leader teaches us the importance of doing something.
No.
In this crooked game of power politics here in America,
yeah,
the Negro, namely the race problem, integration, civil rights issue, are all nothing but tools used by the whites who call themselves liberals against another group of whites who call themselves conservatives.
I just learned that.
Either to get into power or to retain power. Among whites here in America, the political teams are no longer divided into Democrats and Republicans. The whites who are now struggling for control of the American political throne are divided into liberal and conservative camps. The white liberals from both parties cross party lines to work together toward the same goal. And white conservatives from both parties do likewise.
Coming up, nobody in my household knew the difference between conservative and liberal. Most blacks still don't know today. You just vote Democrat because they tell you about racism and all the stuff that white people did to you. Isn't it amazing that some group of whites are telling you that another group of whites are bad? Why would that be the case? Unless they was looking to get something out of you. And then promise you all this shit. and you never get it. Let me turn Malcolm back on, y'all.
In this crooked game of power politics here in America, the Negro, namely the race problem, integration, civil rights issue, are all nothing but tools used by the whites who call themselves liberals against another group of whites who call themselves conservatives, either to get into power or to retain power. Among whites here in America, the political teams are no longer divided into Democrats and Republicans. The whites who are now struggling for control of the American political throne are divided into liberal and conservative camps. The white liberals from both parties cross party lines to work together toward the same goal. And white conservatives from both parties do likewise. The white liberal differs from the white conservative only in one way. The liberal is more deceitful, more hypocritical than the conservative. Both want power, but the white liberal is the one who has perfected the art of posing as the Negro's friend and benefactor.
Trump didn't act friendly.
And by winning the friendship and support of the Negro, the white liberal is able to use the Negro as a pawn or a weapon in this political football game that is constantly raging between the white liberals and the white conservatives.
And guess who's getting kicked?
The American Negro is nothing but a political football. And the white liberals control this ball through tricks or tokenism, false promises of integration and civil rights. In this game of deceiving and using the American Negro, the white liberals have complete cooperation of the Negro civil rights leader, who sell our people out for a few crumbs of token recognition, token gains, token progress. In the New York Tribune,
in an editorial dated February the 5th, 1960, they pointed out that out of 11 million qualified Negro voters, only 2,700,000 actually take time to vote. This means that, roughly speaking, only 3 million out of the 11 million Negroes who are qualified to vote take an active part. And the remaining 8 million remain voluntarily inactive. And yet it is this small minority, the 3 million Negro voters, who help determine who will be the next president.
Another thing that I have privy to that Malcolm didn't have privy to is time, social media, and the common sense that's involved with all of it. They use projection. I can see now, like, the brown or native people have never been the minority in this landmass. It's impossible for a couple of reasons. You heard about how harsh it was for those people to come from Europe, a different climate, to maintain food, to maintain themselves. They were dying off. They wouldn't come to a land where people who already been here that know how to raise families, children in the climate that they lived in, to come here and out reproduce them. And even in today, and this isn't race or anything like that, but some animals in the wild produce a lot faster and easier than others. Genetically, we're like two cats, a tiger, a lion. They could both feed lions, but their reproduction, their litter could be different and how stressful it is on them. White Caucasian Americans don't reproduce at the rate that blacks do for a couple of reasons. Clinically, you can look at the data with that. Who gets more abortions versus who takes more fertility drugs? That's easy common sense shit. All of the abortion clinics pretty much in the hood, while the fertility clinics are in nice hospitals. Blacks don't use fertility drugs. Fertile myrtle. You ever heard of that? That saying, you can look at a black woman and get her pregnant. It's never been a time where the brown people that's indigenous to this land, and that's who I am. Y'all might claim Africa, but that's fine. That's another thing that they told you that you never researched, never put your fingers on. You just went with it. All right, go do some research. You're not gonna out reproduce the indigenous people with you coming from somewhere else. The mortality rate of your kids, even now in today's climate, you know what I'm saying? It's just a struggle for some of my Caucasian Americans to have these babies, like you see it. And I don't deal with racism, it's just the classification, so we can get a brace, you know, we can get a fucking bar for what I'm talking about. You can research it yourself. And just because you don't research it don't mean that it's not the truth. You can't just, well, you can say it's not the truth and leave it alone, but that don't make it the truth, you know. And then you lying to yourself. You're not lying to me or somebody else that's telling you. You're the one that's getting shorted because it's information that you can use to make better judgments about shit. When you're informed, you're not afraid. So that's another myth that these people believe, you know. It's more them. And it's not. It's never been. That's why the pitch is so hard for you as a people to vote. Get out and vote. Get out and vote. The powers that be, they don't have your numbers because not everybody registers. Like all these polls that they take in America, they tell you that 70% of the people did X, Y, Z. You haven't participated in that shit. It's never been 70% that's participated. Did you hear the numbers Malcolm brought up? 11,000, roughly 3,000 of them voted out of, well, 3 million out of 11 million, right? The numbers are bigger, way bigger than that, but the percentages are still the same. So they're asking the blacks to vote because they know it's more you than anybody. They're talking about Latinos. That's a lie as well. It's you, black, so-called black Americans, indigenous. Now, the Europeans made it with some of you different tribes or whatever, more ignorant tribes, and had offsprings. And y'all calling these people natives because they have the stringy hair characteristics, but a brownish red hue on their skin. We know what children of different skin tones of melanin look like. And to take further from these indigenous people, they created another people, called them natives, and gave them what they knew they could take back from them. But you, as the original landlords, you claim in Africa, because I guess you don't know any better. You don't want to know any better anyway. I'm right at 41 minutes, y'all. I just wanted to come in and chop it up this morning, because the world going to chop it up with some bullshit. So this is my vaccine, my shot into the world's arm. You know, they want to force the vaccine on us. I'm going to force this truth vaccine of the creator back on the fucking world. So let me shout y'all out. Roll calling, Nephew Jarrell. Shout out to you, fam. Appreciate the text. Little brother Brennan, shout out to you. OGP, my man, shout out to you. Dr. Chu, big shout out to you. DJ Tarzan, my house DJ. What up, bro? Shout out to you. To the sisters, Jackie, love you, sis. Crystal, love you too, sis. Sister Mary Molly, shout out to you. Up in Philly, who else? Cislo, shout out to you. Philly Fly Girl, saw you in the comments. Shout out to you as well. The brother Pootski, the barber, I almost forgot my fam. Shout out to you, Poot. This is brand, y'all, the love brand. See, I'm rocking it. This shit is fly, it's fresh. I mess with it big time. Probably going to cop another hat this weekend, but that's the love brand. You can see that on my IG page. Anybody that follows from IG, shout out to y'all. Drop some info in the comments, y'all. I will shout you out because I do appreciate y'all showing up. I know it's all kinds of stuff going on in the world today. So I appreciate y'all coming to the channel as much as you do. So shout out to y'all. Shalom, Islam, Shalom Aleikum, Alhamdulillah. God bless and enjoy y'all day, folks.